Hello students, we are beginning with a new chapter today, a new chapter of economics of your social sciences class 10th. This is the fourth chapter of your book, Globalization of the Indian Economy, a very interesting chapter which is connected with your day-to-day activities, with your day-to-day purchasing, with your day-to-day choices in the market. Gone are the days when we were very young, we were small, and we used to have a very limited brands of things in the market. In fact, we had no choices. There were limited brands of shoes. Like for example, for us, when we were in the childhood, Bata was the name of the shoes. Bata means shoes and chappals, shoes and slippers. Eskimos meant dress. And certain products, they were limited in the country. We were unknown about any other product, particularly the things which are made in the foreign countries, which are made abroad, they were not available to us. Only in our class, those students could have imported chocolates, imported pen, imported pencil box. Either their father or their relatives or friends, they had been abroad. But gone are the days when on the Indian roads we used to see Ambassadors, Fiat, LML Vespa, Bajaj scooter. We used to see all these limited brands on the Indian roads. But today we are using cars, we are using products by the topmost companies of the world. They have been produced. We have choices. When we go to the market, we can compare the products. We have so many brands of clothes, we have so many brands of cars, scooters, even cycles, motorcycles. So, in summarized way, in a matter of years, our markets have been transformed totally. There is a big revolution. There is a big change in the market. A person who would have lived in India 50, 60 years before and would have returned to India and would be surprised to see the brands. And sometimes it is very difficult for us to make choices. There are so many choices before us. Not only as consumers we are benefited by it, but even the producers, even the manufacturers, they have been benefited. Because when we are becoming global, when foreign products are coming into the market, the local producers, you know, they become enthusiastic. And they also try to compete with the products of the foreign goods. The goods that are produced by the topmost multinational companies. Even the producers have the chance to improve their products, and they have the chance to improve their technology, adopt new science and technology, to produce goods which are as per quality to the goods coming from outside. So globalization is this process of transformation. Globalization means when the markets of the different countries are integrated together, when the goods and services are not only exchanged within the country, but they are exchanged with the whole world. Globalization is a reality today. All the countries are global today because there are so many demands, there are so many products, there are so many choices that no country can fulfill its choice on its own. We have to depend on the others, either for the raw materials, either for the cheap labor, for the skilled labor, for the markets. We are going to discuss all these interesting things in this chapter, and it will give you a sense in which the world in which you are living today and how you can take advantage of all these things. Becoming global is a matter of concern. Let me tell you, India became global after 1990. In 1991-92, we became global. We will study in this chapter, in the preceding chapter, we will study the reasons what made India to become global and what made India not to become global when we became independent. Because we have discussed so many times about colonialism, about foreign powers in the country. So we will discuss all these important topics in this chapter. So students, I hope you got some idea about globalization. Yes, globalization means the process of exchange of goods and services between the countries. It is a process through which countries become global, and because of globalization, the whole world, the whole globe today have been converted, have been shortened into a large village where it is very easy to move here and there. People are very familiar to each other. They go to each other's house and they are just like families. So today the world have been converted into a large village because of globalization. In the NCRT, pages 55, 56, 57, 58, four pages you can go through today, which we are going to discuss here. So globalization, today we are global, almost all the countries are global today. There are global institutions, WTO, World Trade Organization, you must have read in your junior classes, that regulate all these transformation between the countries and trade between the countries. Trade is the main cause for the countries to become global. As I told you, demand for more raw materials, skilled labor, cheap labor, markets, etc. And moreover, prestige and power. That is a human nature. So all these things we are going to discuss. And this was just to give you an idea of globalization. We start with an example. An example will give you an idea that how globalization enables the producers to save their money as well as to produce goods which are excellent in the market. Because remember, in globalization, only good products, only good quality products and with affordable prices, only they would survive in the market. We will discuss one example, and then it will give you more idea about globalization, how globalization works. So at the back on the blackboard, you can see spreading production across the countries. First of all, meaning of globalization. We have discussed about globalization. You can be asked in 1 mark. You can be asked in 3 marks in board examination. Do it very carefully. Then this is a long answer. Production across the countries. A very good example is given in your NCRT. An industrial equipment making company is there. Industrial equipment making company is there. Gets their products designed in the US research centers. They are going to produce industrial equipments, and they decide to get it designed in the US research centers. Correct? Then, when the equipments are designed, they decide to get them manufactured in China. In China, they decide to get the goods manufactured, and then all the goods are assembled in Mexico and Eastern Europe. And the customer care centers are there in India. 4 points I have given you. Designing somewhere, manufacturing somewhere else, assembling and distribution somewhere else, customer care center somewhere else. What do you see in this example? In this example, you see, or we see, that in globalization, the production process is divided into smaller units. Although when you hear it, when I am explaining, you must be finding it very complex. Somewhere designing, somewhere manufacturing, somewhere assembling and distribution, somewhere customer care centers and blah blah. You must be thinking of it. Yes. You know, by doing this, a multinational company, which is a part of globalization, can save their about 50% to 60% cost. Correct? Now we will clarify this example. First of all, they get their equipments designed in US research centers. Because in US, United States of America, it has excellent technology and the equipments are designed better and cheaper. So they save cost over there. Better equipments, affordable. Then they do not get them manufactured in US, because in US labor is very costly. So after getting them designed in the US research centers, they asked the Chinese workers to produce goods because in China there is cheap labor. So they save cost here also in getting their produced ready. And then all the products, all the industrial equipments are assembled in Mexico and Eastern Europe. Why? Because from Mexico and Eastern Europe, markets are very, most of the markets, not all, but most of the markets of the world are very close. Correct? Because from Mexico and Eastern Europe, it is easy to sell the products. It is easy to give these services, give these products to other countries, sell them to other countries. And finally, the fourth point, their customer care centers are in India. Because in India, there are youth, young, girls and boys, English speaking, very intelligent. Our students get very vast bookish knowledge and they can understand even a minute aspect of the equipment of the products. They can understand all these things and they can give us a very good customer care service. And so many young children, boys and girls, they are employed in it. So this is how globalization and the MNCs, they work. They spread production, they divide their production process into smaller units, and they can save their 50 to 60%. You can see in your NCRT page number 55-56, there is an exclamation mark. Exclamation mark, yes. Oh, they can cut 50 to 60% cost like this by doing all these things, by spreading their production. So this is how globalization works. This is how MNCs are spreading production across the countries. Understand? I hope you better understand with this example. Then we switch over to our third topic today. First topic, meaning of globalization, I have given you with example. Second topic, just now we have finished the spreading of production by the multinational companies in globalization. Now we will discuss the interlinking production across the countries by MNC. Remember, MNCs are playing a very important role in globalization. So our third topic today is linking of interlinking production across the countries. And before this topic, you must know two terms given in your NCRT page number 56, investment and foreign investment. For the production process, to carry out the production work, there is some investment, means assets are bought, land, building, machinery, etc., etc. Investment is done. Capital investment, other investments, they are done by the producer who want to produce something is known as investment. Correct? But when a producer is buying assets, not in its own country, but in another country for production, a person is buying, an entrepreneur or a producer is buying land, machine, building, etc. in any other country, leaving his own country, that will be called as foreign investment. These are one mark term, both the term. Investment within the country when a producer buys assets like land, building, machinery, etc. and other assets. This is called investment. And foreign investment simply means when these assets are brought, when these assets are bought in other countries for production. Like for example, some foreigners are coming to India, they are buying assets for production, that will be a foreign investment, or vice versa. If Indian producers are going to other country and there they are buying assets like building, etc., land, building, machinery, etc., that will be called as foreign investment. Is it clear? Now we will discuss this long topic, 5 marks, interlinking production across the countries, and separately you get it 3 marks each. 3 marks each topic, and on the whole it is a 5 marks topic in your board examination. First of all, setting up production jointly. Whenever MNC go to the other countries, they search for local producers. Like for example, when American Ford Motors came to India in 1995. They wanted some equipments for their motor cars. For producing cars, they needed some small products, which they felt that if they produce all these small products, that will be little benefit for them. So they look for small producers, and they join them, and they ask them to supply them the other equipments. Like American Ford Motors, when it came to India, it joined Mahindra and Mahindra. Mahindra and Mahindra is a local company of India, which was producing trucks, tires, etc. at that time. And American Ford Motors, they jointly, they are working with them and they join with them. Now the benefit here is twofold. It is twofold benefit when MNC join a local company. Twofold benefit is MNC get all the small equipments for their production process, for their production work. Correct? And the local companies, even they are ready to be joined by the MNCs, because not only they get extra capital to enhance their production and the production quality, but also to learn something else, to learn new technology from the MNCs. So even the local companies are ready to join them. So the benefit is twofold. MNC is also getting part it into two. MNC is benefited by joining the local companies, and even the local companies are ready to join the MNC, because not only they are getting extra capital to uplift, to upgrade their production, they are also learning new technology from MNC. They are also learning new techniques for production. So this is the first way by which MNC is interlinking production in globalization. Then buying them up. Sometimes multinational companies, they buy the local companies. And this question comes in board examination, that what is the which one is the easiest or the cheapest way for the MNCs to interlink production across the countries? Answer is by buying them. Why? Because MNCs have wealth, immense wealth. MNCs have wealth exceeding the budget of a developing country like India. The whole budget, annual budget of the country like India, MNCs are having money more than that. And it is very easy for them to buy any local company and carry on production. For the last few years, you must have read Ranbaxy, the medicinal company, was sold. In your NCRT, the example of Parak Food is given. Parak Food was a very, very reputed brand in India. It was producing food products, plus it had 4 oil refineries, and it was doing very well, Parak Foods. Later on, when globalization began in India after 1991, Parak Foods was purchased by Cargill Foods, a US company. K-A-R-G-I-L, Cargill Foods. It was purchased by Cargill Foods. Today, all the production process of the Parak Food is looked after by the Cargill Foods, and they have all these oil refineries also under them, 4 oil refineries, and they are producing 5 million pouches of refined oil daily. That means they are selling also. And they have brand ambassadors like Sanjeev Kapoor, the cooking chef, etc. So they are doing it very well. So this is the cheapest way, by buying the local companies. This is the cheapest way, easiest way for the MNCs to interlink production across the countries. It is very easy for them. And sometimes students ask me that why local companies are ready to be bought? Why they are ready? Yes, you purchase us. Because they get such a lot of money from the MNC that they had never thought of. They had never thought of that they would be getting such a lot of money for their company. So even they get purchased by the MNC. And the third one is by placing order, the last topic for today. Interlinking production across the countries, the subheading third one, that is by placing order. Sometimes for small products, MNCs are not interested to produce, like footwear, sports items, etc. Garments, small garments, cotton garments, etc. MNCs are not interested. Better, they place order to the other developing countries particularly. They place order. Even by placing orders, the whole monopoly means whole sole right, is in the hands of MNCs, multinational companies. they decide how much money they will pay to the particular company. Like for example, in India, local companies, they get order for footwear, for sports items, a very famous outside India sports items, and cotton garments, garments for children, etc. They get order. But in that order, the monopoly is in the hands of multinational companies. They decide how much they will pay. They decide that what will be the tenure of completing the order. They also tell the people whom they are ordering that do not put any tag or price, the tag of price or tag of quality on the products, because all these rights are in the hands of multinational companies, and they do it. Local companies do according to the instructions of the multinational companies. They do it accordingly. Correct. So like this, by placing orders also, interlinking production across the countries can be done in globalization by the multinational companies. Okay, they place the orders, but they keep everything from money till the tag of quality, tag of price, etc. They will fix. Only the local companies will, only they will produce in limited resources, in limited amount. Correct. So that is all for today. Go through all these topics and we will do it further in the next lecture. Thank you, students.